So I don't know why this is twisted, because the recording was wrong, but she could walk, and this is the way she could walk with her twisted neck. She could never look up. She couldn't know where she's going. This was the CT. We tried to look at the vascular anatomy. The only thing we discovered, that the vertebral artery enters the cervical spine at C6 and not below that. This was the 3D anatomy. And finally, what we planned was, on SurgiMap, there is a software available called SurgiMap. You can feed all the parameters, all the images in it, and then you can plan the surgery on SurgiMap. And in SurgiMap, we planned that we need to do osteotomies at two levels. We need an osteotomy at C7-T1 level, and then lower down in the dorsal spine to try and make her straight. And that's what we ended up doing. We tried to get her into the theater and try to see what position are we going to operate, whether we can use the O-arm or not. But her deformity was such that it was impossible to do with an O-arm. So we had to do with pre-fed images. We used neurophysiological monitoring, the MEP and SSEP, total intravenous anesthesia, no muscle relaxants, so that we could monitor. There was a mouth gag. It was difficult even to intubate, and it was impossible to do a tracheostomy. It was just not possible, because you couldn't get even at the manubrium because of her chin being stuck there. So there was, the only way to intubate was through the nose, and only one nostril, because of deviation of the neck, only one nostril was clear. So, but our anesthetists were very good. They managed to intubate through that one nostril, and a nasotracheal intubation helped us do this surgery. This was what her final position. Actually, we operated in this position because there was no other way we could get her onto the table. So this was the position we operated, with a head clamp supporting it, and the patient in a some kind of a sitting position, or semi-sitting position. This was the incision which we used, the exposure. This is what the surgery was planned, that you do an osteotomy like this, and then you close the gap, making the neck go up. So it sounds very simple, but it's a dangerous thing to do. But this is exactly what we managed to do. You can see the roots, two or three roots. I think it's C5, C6, or C6, 7, and D1, and rest of the bones. And through the pedicle, we went into the body. We cored out the body. That's how we went inside, from either side. And once you core out the body, then all you have to do is to lift up the neck like this, and it'll snap. You can hear the crack, crack. The anterior cortex breaks and the neck becomes straight. And this is what we did. I think there are videos, but we can skip all that. So you can see earlier the chin, where the chin was, it was stuck to the chest. And now immediately after surgery, I was still closing from the back. Somebody put his hand under the chin and took a picture just to show that how much correction we have got. And there was quite a lot of buzz in the OT on that day. But we finally closed up, fixed it with the rod, the cervix and the cervical spine and the occiput. And this was the correction which we could get from this angle. We managed to get her neck up to this angle. So the next thing was the dorsal. We need to do correction here as well to make her a bit straighter. And then maybe we need to do a similar correction at the lumbar spine also to get the three. So I think we have done this dorsal as well. I don't know if I have the pictures after the dorsal correction. But this was what she became after the first surgery. She could at least see in front. You know, earlier she couldn't see at all, and this was ultimately after the first surgery. And after the second surgery, she became even better. She's even straighter. Now, what is left is she's got a little stoop because of the lumbar thing, and her neck is tilted like this. But otherwise, she's quite straight. So the last part of the operation is to straighten the neck and to do a lumbar, or maybe not do a lumbar, just leave her at whatever position she is. Thank you for your... So these are the cases where you would need a pedicle screw. Otherwise, most of